So all this basically happened in August and September, and I think on my birthday in August also, she got a cake and all the friends came over to my house.
Everyone was inside, we came out, and then I was like, come, let's go, I feel like eating ice cream. And then I just sat in the car and we started driving, and I got really worried because he was like some drunk random guy and I didn't know who he was, and I was going alone with him. I got really scared. But then he went and he like got ice cream for me.
At that point, I guess I knew it's going somewhere, because no one would just simply get a cake for some met recently, So
we went to the smoking zone at Goldman, and then he said, hey, I like you. So I said, okay. And then he waited for a few seconds and then he's like, do you like me too? I said, yeah, I like you.
Even if there are arguments or disagreements, at the end of the day, we should both come out smiling. That's the promise I would want to keep.
I trouble him a lot. I think I'm quite high maintenance, but he manages that really well, so.
She's very affectionate, and that makes you feel special, and that makes you feel wanted in someone's life, so that was something that I really liked about him, and I still do, I guess.
I'm in Singapore because of him, obviously. He has told me himself, nobody will love him like how I love him.
I've seen the world, done it all, had my cake now. I am immense, brilliant, and billion now. Hot summer nights, mid-July, when you and I were forever wild. The crazy days, city lights, the way you'd
if you're in a foreign land, again, you don't know many people over there. So, we basically spend a lot of time with each other. And I think that automatically, you know, paved the way into the bigger decision, which was eventually bound to happen. So.